Welcome to my first video lecture. We will get start with the very first topic, which is experimental chemistry. You all know that experiments are a backbone of chemistry. So we will start with experimental design, in which we will discuss physical quantities, units and apparatuses. So let's start. What is physical quantity? Physical quantity is defined as a measurement of physical properties. Physical quantities requires two components, such as number and unit. So why is it important to know about physical quantities? As you all know, since the chemistry is a quantitative science, that's why amount of substances and energies must always be expressed in numbers and units. Physical quantities which we are going to study are mass, time, temperature and volume. How we measure mass? As a unit is kilogram, smaller masses are measured in grams, while heavier objects in industries like vehicles and large cargo boxes will measured in unit ton. Remember, 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams and 1 ton is equal to 1000 kilograms. Mass of a substance can be measured by using beam balance and electronic balance. In chemistry experiments, smaller masses are measured by using electronic balance with an accuracy up to 0.01 grams. Measuring time. SI unit is second. Other units, which are minutes and hour, are used for longer intervals of time. Remember, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. In laboratory, stopwatch is used to measure time. There are two types of stopwatches, analog stopwatch and digital stopwatch. Accuracy of analog stopwatch is 0.1 second, while accuracy of digital stopwatch is 0.01 second. Now the question is, what is accuracy? Accuracy is how close a measured value is to the real value. Measuring temperature. SI unit is Kelvin, denoted by capital K. Other unit, degree Celsius, is also commonly used. Temperature in Kelvin is equal to temperature in degree Celsius plus 273. Note that there is no degree sign before K. Thermometer is used for measuring temperature. This is bulb. Inside the bulb there is a liquid, which is mercury, capillary tube, and this is stem. There are two types of liquids which are used in thermometers. One is mercury and the other is alcohol. Alcohol is most commonly used. Why? Because it is harmless as compared to mercury, because mercury is dangerous. In school laboratories, two types of thermometers are used, mercury thermometer and alcohol thermometer, to measure a temperature. So each division in these thermometers represent 1 degree Celsius, and accuracy of these type of thermometer is 0.5 degree Celsius. Temperature sensors such as data logger is also used to measure the temperature. Data logger is mostly used taking measurements outdoors. Data logger is shown in the picture. This is how it is used to measure the temperature and tells the reading. How to measure volume? SI unit is cubic meter, or cubic centimeter and cubic decimeter are also used. Remember, 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 dm cube and 1 dm cube is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Mostly bottled drinks which are sold are in liters and milliliters. Remember, 1 liter is equal to 1 dm cube. Now how do we measure volumes of liquids? Yes, there are some apparatuses which are commonly used to measure the volume of liquids, such as conical flask, beaker, bulb pipette, burette and measuring cylinder. So depending upon the volumes we are measuring and how much accuracy of the volume is needed, we use different apparatuses regarding that. Degree of accuracy of apparatus used to measure volume of liquids. Apparatus measuring cylinder which has accuracy nearest to 0.5 centimeter cube. Burette measures out nearest to 0.05 centimeter cube. While pipette measures fixed volume of liquid such as 20 centimeter cube or 25 centimeter cube. What apparatus you would use to measure exactly 25 centimeter cube of sodium hydroxide solution? The answer is pipette. Pipette measures exactly the fixed volume. Curved surface. That curved surface is called meniscus. How to take meniscus reading? By keeping eye in front of a reading which is 46 ml. Correct position for taking the reading is the center one, the red line. Now how do we measure volume of gases? By a gas range. So a gas range is used to measure volume of a gas. Measures maximum volume of 100 centimeter cube. So we have discussed about quantities, physical quantities which commonly used in experiments of chemistry. First mass, time, temperature and volume. So don't forget to like and do subscribe my channel for more chem videos. Thank you for this. Bye bye.